So we are looking at. Okay. So
which
let me.
1,020.
So I'm just gonna read it in English.
Don't read it in Arabic. Because the Arabic
sir,
is just, okay, I'll read
sir,
it in Arabic.
Do you know we'll Arabic?
No, no, we'll read it.
He doesn't know Arabic.
No, we'll read it.
Okay, I'm gonna read it English and then you follow it from the Arabic. So we are discussing Surah Ayat al-Kursi, which has been recited by many Muslims before they go to bed. Is it the word of Allah or is it the word of Satan? I am reading from Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 1020. Okay?
1020, yeah?
Abu Huraira, may Allah please be him reported. Okay? Messenger of Allah, put me in charge of charity of Ramadan. Somebody came to me and began to take away from some foodstuff. I caught him and I said, I must take you to the messenger of Allah. He said, I am a needy man with a large family, so I have a pressing need. I let him go. When I saw messenger of Allah next morning, he asked me, oh Abu Huraira, what did your captive do last night? I said, messenger of Allah, he complained of a pressing need and a big family. I felt pity for him and I let him go. He said, he told you a lie and he will return. I was sure according to the sayings of the messenger of Allah, yeah, he will return. I was sure according to the sayings of messenger of Allah, he would return. I waited for him. He sneaked up again and began to steal foodstuff from the sadaqah. I caught him and then I said, I must take you to the messenger of Allah. He said, let go of me. I am a needy man. I have a bare expense for a big family. I will not come back. So I took a pity on him and let him go. I went at dawn to the messenger of Allah, who asked me, oh Abu Huraira, what did your captive do last night? I replied, oh messenger of Allah, he complained of a pressing want and burden of a big family. I took pity on him, so I let him go. He said, he told you a lie and he will return. That man came back again to steal foodstuff.
So
I arrested him.
Yeah.
Yeah. I arrested him and then said, I must take you to the messenger of Allah. And this is the last of three times. You promised that you wouldn't come back again, but you did. He said, let go of me. I shall teach you some words. I'll teach you some words with which Allah benefit you. I asked, what are those words? He replied, when you go to bed, recite Ayat al-Kursi, Surah 2, 255. For there will be the garden appointed over you from Allah, and Satan will not be able to approach you until morning. So I let him go. Next morning, the messenger of Allah asked me, what did your prisoner do last night? I answered, he promised to teach me some words which he claimed will benefit me before Allah. So I let him go. The messenger of Allah said, what are those words that he taught you? I said, he taught me, when you go to bed, recite Ayat al-Kursi from the beginning to the end. And then surah goes on. Allah, none has right to be worshipped but he, the ever living, or the one who sustains and protects all that existed. Neither slumber or sleep take over him. Blah, blah, blah. It goes on like that's the whole surah.
You know who that man is?
Just a moment. I'm going to tell you. Actually, Muhammad is going to tell you. Okay? So that's all the verse. Okay? He replied, by reciting it, there will be a garden appointed over you from Allah who will protect you during the night. And Satan will not able to come near to you until morning. The messenger of Allah said, verily, he has told you the truth, but yet he is a liar. Oh, Abu Huraira, do you know who you were speaking last night? Abu Huraira says, no. Muhammad said, he was a Satan. So, Satan, according to Sunni sources, I know you are Shia, according to Sunni sources, is the source of the chapter of the Quran, verse of the Quran that people recite before they go to bed. Surah 255. Okay? So therefore, I am asking you the question to the Sunnis, why eternal word of Allah contains the word of Satan, which they recite, they go to bed.
So regardless of being Shia or Sunni.
Sorry, if you don't want to be on the camera, can you just come here, turn your back to the camera? Because because I don't know how to do the blurring of the people. So if you turn your back to the camera,
okay.
Yeah, sorry, he doesn't want to be on the camera. Turn
regardless
back.
Of being a Shia or Sunni, this hadith, it doesn't show that it was recited by Satan, or it was, or the source of it is Satan. All it says, all it shows, is that one of the companions of the Prophet, i.e. Abu Huraira, he was living there, and a man came up to him. He said to him, "I'm a needy person. I need some help." He said to him, "Go, and I will ask the Prophet for some help for you." Then he said to him, this happened three times. Then Abu Huraira said to him, "Recite this verse, the verse of Kursi. I don't know what chapter it is."
Surah 255.
Yeah. He said to him, "Recite that verse, and you shall be protected from the Satan. The Satan will not come up to you." But the point is, the companion knew this verse before the Satan. So the Satan is not the source of the...
Okay,
of,
let
of
me respond
verse.
To that. Let me respond to that. Are you Shia Muslim? Are you Sunni Muslim?
I'm a Shia Muslim.
Okay.
Regardless of me accepting...
Just a moment. Okay, just
this doesn't show that...
Just a moment. Let me respond. I listened to you. Now I'm going to respond to what you said. According to Muhammad, Muhammad identifies the one who visited Abu Huraira as the Satan.
Yeah, he said he's Satan.
So Muhammad identifies him as a Satan.
Yeah, the Satan, okay? Imitated
just a moment. Satan appears as a man who is a poor, who is a big family, okay?
Yeah.
And then Satan gives you the ayat al-Kursi, okay?
He didn't give it to us.
Muhammad
Abu
doesn't
Huraira,
say, no, Abu Huraira or Muhammad doesn't say, yes, we are aware of those verses. Satan says, recite this before you go to bed.
Abu Huraira said it, not Satan.
Sir,
Abu Huraira told the man.
No, sir. I read it again for you. You are misrepresenting the hadith. I'm not sure if it is that intentional or not intentional. I'm reading it for you again, okay? So, what did your prisoner do last night? I answered, he promised to teach me some words. The one who came to ask for the food, steal the food, promised to teach him some words, and then he taught Surah 255. That's according to Sunni sources. Before you came to the conversation.
Yes.
So okay. So
you are
okay. Let me just make it clear. So are you telling?
Right,
okay. So it was the Satan.
The man is the one who told Abu Huraira to recite the.
And who was identified as the Satan?
That's fine. Now you have to prove to me that this verse was not known before the Satan came to Abu Huraira.
I don't have to prove you that.
No,
let
because,
me just respond.
Because the hadith does not say
name?
That the Satan
What's
Yusuf,
your name? Yusuf, let me respond. Okay? Hadith clearly says this verse is gonna give in to the Abu Huraira, and Abu Huraira is gonna learn those verses, okay?
No, he needed.
No.
He
no.
Said to him, read the verse.
No, it doesn't say read the verse. Don't fool me.
Hadith,
I've got the hadith here.
Does the hadith
and then we already
the
caught you as you were misrepresenting. Okay? So I read it for you again. I am gonna teach you. Satan says, I'm gonna teach you. If Abu Huraira knew that, it was good opportunity for Muhammad and his Sahaba Abu Huraira to say, oh, excuse me, we know that verse. They doesn't say that. Satan says, I'm gonna teach you. And then Satan teaches Abu Huraira. Muhammad identifies that man as the Satan, and that verse is in the Quran, and Sunni Muslims recite it before they go to
Listen,
bed.
Abu Huraira may know that verse, but he
no,
may not know
no,
the effect
it
of
says, it. Sir, it says, let me teach you. Abu Huraira is promising to teach. Okay? Sir, are you British?
Yes.
Okay, he's British, okay? If I say, I'm gonna teach you something, okay? Is that means, oh, there are the things, I'm gonna tell you something you already know, or is it something new I'm gonna make you to learn.
It's gonna be new, isn't it?
So it will be new. Okay.
He's teaching him the effects. Okay. He's telling him the effects of that verse. If you recite
just,
it,
just hold. I'm gonna give him it. To make it make it.
Can I just? Sorry to interrupt.
Let's speak to Scholar.
If you read the narration,
text, yeah.
Go to the part where, upon the third attempt, the
okay.
third time, when he start to teach him something, correct? Read it.
I read it. Let me find the third part.
Yeah.
Okay.
He said, "Let me teach you something."
Yeah. Let me come to that part.
Yeah.
Okay. He said.
Yes.
He told. I'm just gonna read it from a little bit up there. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
He told you a lie, and he will return. The man came again, and then steal the footstuff.
Yeah.
I arrested him, and then said, I must take you to the Messenger of Allah.
Correct.
And this is the last of three times. You promised that you would not come back again.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
But you did. He said, let go of me. I shall teach you some words which may Allah benefit you. I asked, what are those words? He replied, when you go to bed, recite surah for three times to be guardian appointed over you from Allah. And Satan will not able to touch you.
Please go back.
Where do you want me to go back?
Let me teach you. And go slow, please. Don't go fast. Let me teach you something.
Let go of me. I shall teach you some words which Allah may benefit you.
Yes.
I ask, what are those words? He doesn't know the words.
Yes.
I ask, what are those words? He replied, when you go to bed, recite Surah 255.
Yeah.
Ayat al-Kursi. I'm just putting.
He said, read Ayat al-Kursi.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't say read Ayat al-Kursi.
In Arabic,
Arabic says read.
Recite. No, it says recite, and then Hadith goes. Satan tells what he needs to recite.
Can I read
Satan
the Arabic?
Goes on and then tells what he needs to recite.
No,
and then Satan says, this is what you need
no,
to recite.
Completely.
Satan
read.
Says, read Ayat al-Kursi.
This is an important point. Read where it says, I'm going to teach you.
I read it again, okay?
Don't say 255. There's no 255 here.
In the parentheses, it says Ayat al-Kursi.
That's the edition of the editor.
Can you see a number?
Sir, I can't do that much. When Muslims are intentionally deceiving, they are just making
the case. You have to be sincere in the translation.
Excuse me.
You have to be honest
and
sincere.
Excuse me.
There is no 255.
Excuse me. Let me respond.
Uh-huh.
Let me respond.
Yes.
Here is the hadith copy-paste from sunnah.com.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes, yes. I have it here.
Copy-paste.
I have the Arabic version.
Look at here. Look
Your
at,
English version
look at
is
here.
Not.
It is copy-paste from the sunnah.com.
Okay.
Let me finish.
Yes, yes.
Let me finish,
right,
okay?
Fine.
So as it's been copied-paste,
yes.
Author has been very helpful and then tells us the word he needs to recite are those words and then author clearly tells us, those are the words,
Let
okay?
Let me teach you, yeah, say that again.
I ask, what are those words? He replied, when you go to bed, recite Ayat al-Kursi for three For there will be a guardian appointed over you from
wait,
Allah.
Wait. Recite Ayat al-Kursi. And what
For else? There will be guardian.
No. The Arabic doesn't say that.
Recite Ayat al-Kursi.
No, listen. I'll read the Arabic and translate it my way. Yeah? It says, قلت ما هو قال إذا أويت إلى فراشك. If you go to bed, فقرأ آيات الكرسي in brackets, read the verse of الكرسي, الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم, close bracket, حتى تختم الآية
until you finish the verse.
So that means Abu Huraira
knew
about the verse.
Let me respond.
Please.
Let me respond.
Be honest.
Let me respond.
You're misleading everyone.
Let me respond.
Right.
Okay, let me respond.
You see my point here.
Sir,
the verse was already known to Muslims.
Let me respond.
Otherwise, you would not say until
respond.
You finish the verse.
Let me respond. Let me respond.
Please.
Calm down. Let me respond.
I'm down. I'm calm.
Don't act like, let me respond.
No,
so,
here's the thing.
What is it your...
Is it Hatun or Khatun?
Hatun.
But the Arabic word is Khatun.
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
Doesn't matter how you pronounce my name. It doesn't matter.
Right.
The point is, in the Quran today, we have the word of Satan, which Muslims go to bed before they
it's
recite,
not,
they go to bed. So let me
Satan.
Just respond,
just
sir.
Establish.
Let
the
me respond.
Until you reach the end.
Let me
he did
respond.
Not recite the full
let
verse.
Let me
as
respond.
If it is a new revelation. It was already known to Abu Huraira.
It was already
come
known.
On, please.
You never lived your childhood. Your mom never told you when you in principle agree with someone that you have engagement with them, you wait. So I
no,
listen you
no.
carefully.
Did not your mom
now,
tell you in principle
he did,
that
did,
when you get
did,
with someone,
did,
you have
did.
To wait.
So, now I'm just gonna read it for you, okay?
Go on,
let go of me. I shall teach you some words
okay.
With which Allah may benefit you.
Yeah. Yeah,
Satan is gonna teach.
He's a liar.
Words,
he's a liar.
The
Prophet
friend
says,
of
he
Muhammad.
He told you the truth about Ayatul Kursi.
I ask you, what
Satan
are those words?
Right.
He replied, when you go to bed,
yes.
okay, recite Ayatul Kursi.
Yeah.
From there will be a garden appointment over
that
you for Allah. And Satan will not be able to approach
come here,
you.
Come here.
Who's coming?
Ali,
until
Ali,
morning.
Ali,
so, Ali,
come.
Let, so I
come,
let
come,
him
come.
Go.
Come, come
Ali Dawa, Satan tells you to recite the Ayat al-Kursi, Ali Dawa.
Which website that translates?
Sunnah.com. Sunnah.com.
It's not from Satan. It was already known.
It
the verse
is
was already known.
Satan tells you, I teach you something. Recite this. Muhammad identifies that. Muhammad identifies that man who today 1.84 billion Muslims are reciting the words of as the Satan. So my question to the Muslims, Satan revealed it.
No, you're mistaken.
According to this Sahih Bukhari,
right.
according to your own prophet
okay.
Muhammad,
right.
it was Satan. It was Satan
listen,
who revealed it. All I can tell you, all I can tell you, if you think
yes.
the verse was known before this,
yes.
okay,
yes.
give me the date
yeah.
when this hadith was revealed, Muhammad.
Okay.
Give me the full story, how and when, at the first place, Surah 255 revealed.
Right. Listen, Khatun, when we started, you asked me whether I was a Shia, and I told you I am a Shia Muslim. And when you quoted that Bukhari hadith, huh, I gave you the benefit of the doubt to start with, yes? Until we came to the details of the hadith, correct? Right. Then when I read the hadith, and before I make my judgment, whether it is authentic or I disagree with or whatever, it was clearly said from the hadith that Shaitan told Abu Huraira, read Ayatul Kursi until you reach the end of it. So that means to me and to everyone with common sense that the verse was already known to Abu Huraira. It was not because the Shaitan revealed it. Please, that is it. To me, I'm satisfied, right, that the Ayatul Kursi is not revealed by Shaitan.
What was your name?
Huh?
What was your name?
Abu Karrar.
Abu Karrar.
Abu Karrar.
Or Abu Karrar.
Yes.
So, guys, you all heard the response. You all heard the response. Did you hear answer to my question? Did you hear answer to my question? We haven't heard the answer. If the Surah 255 was revealed before this occasion, while Muhammad confirms it is from the word of Satan, which is in the Quran today, did you hear the reference for that? No. We didn't hear the reference for that. According to your Muslim scholars, I'm sorry, it's not your Muslim scholars because you are Shia. According to Sunni Muslim scholars, translation tells us it is teaching something to Abu Huraira. And Muhammad identifies that person as Satan. My questions to the Sunni Muslims, why today you recite Surah 255?
Yeah.
That's for Surah 33.
Hatun, you've been refuted.
53,
thank you
sorry.
Very much. You've been refuted. You are misconception. You're lying about this hadith.
I am so sorry to tell
you're
you to Shia Muslims that their own source, according to Shia Muslims, Sunni sources are lying.
No, 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 no. Listen, listen.
Sources,
no, 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 no.
According
to the translation, we do not disagree with everything of the Sunni. We do not
your
disagree with everything the Sunni mentioned.
Your prophet confirmed Surah 255
I'm satisfied.
Is the word of Allah.
I'm satisfied that
my question to the
what
Muslims
you're
then
is a
Muslims,
lie. Right?
When are you Arabic going hadith? To wake up? Muslims,
no.
When
you
are you
up.
Going to repent
to give
and give
lying.
Up Muhammad? Muslims, when are you going
to
come
to
and bow down to the Lord Jesus Christ? Muslims, do stop reciting the word of Satan.
That's right.
Muhammad is taking you to hell. Allah is taking you to hell. And Satan is clearly taking you to hell, Muslims. You can't just run away like that. While your tradition simply says it is the word of Allah.
I exposed you. I read the Arabic version and you read the
this
English.
This is my exposed
which is,
version.
Which is not
no, sir,
compatible
it's here.
At all.
I don't care, sir. It
no,
is here. Has been translated by
you.
Sunni sources. No,
it's
Surah 255 is the word of Satan. Surah 53, we already know Muhammad didn't even know the voice of Allah. He put the word of Satan into the Quran.
No, that's your own conclusion.
It's not my own conclusion.
You
according
are,
to Sunni
no,
sources,
no, no, no,
according
not.
To Tabari Khan, Muhammad bowed down and worshipped those pagan gods.
In Arabic, it clearly says.
When are you going to give up Islam?
Why would
when
I?
Are you going to give up
I?
Islam? When
it's
are
the,
you going to stop
the right
reciting
Islam.
The word of Satan?
Islam is
when
the right
are
path.
You going to stop
Islam.
Reciting the word of Satan?
Okay. Islam is the right path. Why would I deviate and go on somewhere else?
If Islam is the right path, Muslims, Satan is the right path according
no,
to you.
It's not.
Quran,
no,
Quran
the
which
verse.
Is a part
listen,
of Islam,
the prophet, what
contains
say?
The word of Satan.
What did he say?
And
the,
you
the
recite.
No,
Sunni
look,
Muslims
look.
Recite that. Every night before they
no,
go to
the
bed.
Prophet said,
therefore,
what did he
all
say about
I
the
can
prophet?
Do is to express how much I concern for your eternity.
Amen.
It is time
no
for
way,
you
no
to
way.
Give up Muhammad.
No
it
way.
Is time
no
for
way.
You to give up Quran. It is time for you to repent and come and worship
wait,
Lord Jesus
no,
Christ.
Honestly,
Satan
time,
is not the, helping.
Okay,
Muhammad
Jesus,
is not
listen,
helping.
Listen.
All
Jesus
they are
happy
doing
with you, lying.
Is taking
would
you
Jesus
to
be happy
hell.
With you lying?
I'm not lying.
No, oh, you are.
He's
you are,
the
I just proved
it. Allah who is the best of deceivers.
I proved that you're lying.
Allah is the best of
deceivers.
He's the source.
Didn't Jesus to teach
Muhammad
you
is
to
lying.
Be honest? To
is
be sincere,
your
Allah
prophet
is honest.
Why are you not sincere?
You're Allah
and
is a liar.
Huh?
Like Allah
Muhammad.
Is the best.
You are dishonest.
Like
yeah, like Muhammad.
Dishonest and insincere.
And he's teaching you to lie.
Is that what the Quran
says? Yeah, all deception
honestly,
belongs to Allah
Jesus
in your
will,
Quran.
Jesus
all
will
deception.
Be so ashamed of you.
Yeah?
So ashamed
all
of
deception.
You claim to
and
be his followers
devil talking.
And yet you lie.
That's the devil talking.